Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a powerful supernova from scratch. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl or Command N or by going to File and New. Make the width 1920 pixels, the height 1080 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Click Custom and click Black or click the box and pick Black. Then click Create or Open. Click the lock icon to unlock the layer and double-click the thumbnail to open its layer style window. Click Gradient Overlay. The blend mode is normal and the opacity is 100%. Click the gradient bar and click the black-white thumbnail. Check Reverse and Align with Layer. The style is radial, the angle is 90 degrees, and the scale is 100%. Click Color Overlay. The blend mode is color. Click the color box, and in the hexadecimal field, type in 5B3307. We'll convert our gradient into a smart object by clicking the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and clicking Convert to Smart Object. This will allow us to enlarge the gradient. Press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. At the top, click the chain link icon between the width and the height. This links both of them so whatever percentage we type into one will be automatically repeated in the other. In either field, type in 195%. Then, click the check mark or press Enter or Return twice. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. Open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Click the Warp Transform icon. Click the Custom tab and click Fisheye. Bend it -100. Then press Enter or Return twice. Convert it into a smart object and change its blend mode to overlay. Go to Filter, Distort, and Twirl. Twirl it 45 degrees. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Open your Transform tool. If you see this message, it's just letting us know that the filters will be temporarily turned off while we use the Transform tool. Just click OK. Click the chain link icon, and either in the width or the height, type in 200. Go to Edit, Transform, and Rotate 180 degrees. Then, as before, click the check mark at the top or press Enter or Return twice. Hide the twirl filter on the copy. And to save space in the Layers panel, collapse the effects on both layers. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Solid Color. Type in B65A00. Change the blend mode to overlay. Adjustment layers affect all the layers below it in the Layers panel, but we want to affect just the one layer below it. To do this, we need to make the adjustment layer into a clipping mask. Either press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac, or you can go to Layer and Create Clipping Mask. Next, we'll add bright, sharp streaks of light emanating from the central core. Make a new layer and fill it with black. Go to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. Make the amount 100%, Gaussian, and monochromatic. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 0.3 pixels. Open the Levels window by pressing Ctrl or Command L. In the Input Shadows field, type in 150, and in the Input Highlights field, type in 160. Go to Filter, Blur, and Radial Blur. The amount is 100, the blur method is zoom, and the quality is best. We'll expand the radial blur once more by pressing Ctrl-Alt-F on Windows or Command-Option-F on a Mac. On earlier versions of Photoshop, press Ctrl or Command-F. Then convert it into a smart object. Change its blend mode to Color Dodge. Go to Filter, Distort, and Twirl. Keep the angle at 45 degrees. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 2 pixels. Lastly, we'll create the star itself. Make the bottom layer active and make a new layer above it. Open your elliptical marquee tool and go to the center. Left click and hold as you press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift and drag out a circular selection from the center approximately this size. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 5 pixels, fill it with black, and deselect it. To center it, press Ctrl or Command A and open your Move tool. Click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then, deselect it. Double-click the thumbnail of the star layer to open its layer style window. Click Inner Glow. Click the box and type in FFBA00. Then click OK. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 100%, and the technique is softer. The source is edge, the choke is 0%, the size is 57 pixels, and the range is 50%. Collapse the effects to save space. Make a new layer. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Make the size temporarily 150 pixels and the hardness 0%. Make the opacity 40% and the flow 100%. Invert your foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard. White is your foreground color. Brush directly over the rim to brighten it. To make your brush bigger, make sure the caps lock key isn't active and press the right bracket key on your keyboard a few times. Continue to brush sparingly over the rim. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.